This could be a barn burner. Bout number four here on Thai Fight League, and it is an international super fight at 65 kilograms. Morocco versus Iran. Two very highly rated non-Thai fighters clashing, going head to head for, I believe, the very first time right now, live on Thai Fight League.
I mean, this is definitely a big Thai fight matchup.
It is indeed, and of course, Yunus Benali, after what we've witnessed here on Thai Fight League, has had a meteoric rise getting into the Thai Fight team. Is that now under threat by that man right there? Poya by Rami Piralga. 22 years of age from Ardabil in Iran. Standing at 177 centimeters, he has a professional record of 37 fights, 29 victories with 7 losses and 1 draw. 3 wins here on Thai Fight against Wedsawan, Chaibari, and most notably and recently, Pet Sung Song on the big Thai Fight.
Now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the black corner. He goes by the name of Yunus Benali, 21 years of age, 187 meters tall from Tangier in Morocco. He has a total of 52 fights, 33 victories and 9 losses.
Now you can see the tail of the tape. Two very young, very experienced Thai Fight League fighters here. Two similar styles as well. Both got knockout power. Both ready to take that next step.
Yeah, it's going to be about who has the hardest shots in this one here. And more in the tank, I should say.
Yeah, of course, like after we saw Yunus Benali here on Thai Fight League, they moved him straight into the Thai Fight team, and he had big fights on the big Thai Fight shows. He did lose, though, one fight. Against, I think it was Pet Pak Mai. Poi, on the other hand, 3-0 here in Thai Fight. And like I said, there could be a lot of pressure here on Yunus Benali because his position within the big Thai Fight, the show that we have 8 times a year, could be very much under threat if he loses here against Poi.
And the thing is, not only does Poi have that knockout power, he has such an unorthodox style as well. Always brings it back to when he knocked his opponent out with a spinning back elbow.
Absolutely.
Really exciting young fighter. Referee in charge for this one is Pulkit Prampayun. Judges ringside to one Ingo Bodden. Patanan Pongsapan and Putjak Ngao Ngam.
All right. Big fight. And a big fight feel as well. We've got in the white corner Poya Bayrami from Iran.
And his opponent in the black corner is Yunus Benali, 65 kilograms for this one.
See some deep breaths there before we remove the Moncon. Three-minute rounds at 65 kilograms.
Really feels intense in here.
It does. Really does.
Both of them bringing a huge amount of support for them. Here we go, round number one. Always wonder who's going to throw the first shot.
Taking this one in a little bit too careful. That was almost Thai style.
That's right. Not to the liking, of course, of referee Pulkit.
Well, there you go. Poya scoring with the first big shot of the fight, going down low to Yunus.
Beautiful sweep there from Poya.
Great start here from Poya.
Great timing from the young Iranian. Both of them still in the stance, so none of them want to make the first mistake, so to speak.
Absolutely. Spot on there, Kevin. Good left high kick from Poya. Right low kick there from Yunus.
We're just going to show how much respect each fighter has for each other.
There's that low kick once again. Yunus reaching down to try and grab a hold of it instead of blocking it.
Yeah, and that could be very dangerous for him. You'd imagine the next one would come to the head.
Yes. Right, looking very relaxed.
And as you said earlier. Good shots there coming in from Poya. It's a three-strike combo. But you said earlier as well that Yunus, he does have a lot of pressure on him for this bout. He has fought in the big Thai fight a couple of times already. Yunus wants to cement his position there. But that man right there, Poya, stands in his way.
The fighters once again looking for low kicks. Poya getting the better of the exchanges and once again finding that left low kick. Sorry, that lower left leg, sorry, of Yunus.
Yeah, but Yunus Benali doing the exact same thing he did before, trying to catch the low kick. You just don't do that. And there's a low kick in return by Yunus Benali. Swing and a miss there from the Moroccan. And a swing and a miss from the Iranian as well.
But he finds once again that leg.
I feel as if there's going to be a high kick.
Ooh! Poya there. I think he just walked into a left hook.
A big left hook of that.
Stunned him momentarily.
This is a good matchup so far.
It really is. Here comes Yunus.
And straight into the clinch. Good positional awareness there from Poya.
I wonder who the fans watching around the world are cheering for right now. End of round number one. Let's have a look at the highlights here from round number one. Very edgy round number one, Kevin.
A very close one, I must say. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if it's a 10-10 on the judges' scorecard. That's just how close it's been. But Poya started off strongly with the low kicks and with that sweep. However, he was caught by Yunus Benali with a hook. Hopefully we can get to see that one on the replay.
Yeah, if I'm going to put my neck on the line, I think that Poya did enough to take the round. I really do.
Yeah, likewise. But not taking that away from the fact that Poya was caught with a hook. Just hoping that we get to see that on the replay, quite honestly. And we don't.
Sorry, Kevin.
That's all right.
All right, well, let's see now. I do feel Yunus Benali is under more pressure. I think Poya took that round. And it's up to Yunus Benali now to try and do something different, to try and cause some issues for Poya Bayrami in the white corner.
Here we go, round number two. Looks like it's straight from where we left off. Another low kick there.
I think he caught him with the right hook as he was going down.
I think it was just an off balance, actually, because Yunus Benali, he did catch the low kick. Now Poya on the back foot. Good kick to the body there from Yunus Benali. Yunus Benali with more intensity in his strikes.
Oh. And again, looking to try and grab that kick instead of blocking it.
And that's exactly why Poya went for the high kick, but I think Yunus Benali had that one scouted.
Good low kick there in reply from Yunus.
Yeah, great timing from Yunus Benali to hit that one, but missed with the kick to the body. Poya surely has come back with some strikes of his own. Another nice low kick there from Yunus, or excuse me, Poya.
And again, targeting that left leg.
That left leg is as red as a fire hydrant at the moment. He's taking so much of them instead of blocking them. And trying to catch them. Which, ladies and gentlemen, 9 times out of 10, you shouldn't be catching low kicks. Better try to block them or try to evade them.
Left and right hand there from Poya, sneaking through the guard.
Big right hand again from Poya. Good block there from Poya. Poya with another low kick. Oh, the red, the swelling on that left leg.
Oh, big right hand there from Poya. Just as Yunus was starting to get a feel for this fight, it starts to cause a little bit of issue for Poya. It's Poya now is being connected with the big shots here in round number two.
Yeah, it was a good idea to go for that lead leg by Poya. It takes away a lot of the power and the punches of Yunus Benali. Right hand just missing again from Yunus Benali, but the kick lands. That one missed though.
Left body shot, overhand right, blocked though by Yunus. Snapping left jab there from Yunus. Attempts it again, misses. Right low kick from Poya.
And still trying to catch those kicks.
Oh,
that's such a bad idea.
They're telling him in the corner to go for that leg.
I think he's already on it, Aaron.
Yeah.
He's done a very good job of that.
They want more leg kicks. It's swollen as well, you can see from this angle.
And he's limping a little bit from that and going for the spectacular, as we see Poya do in every single fight he competes in here on Thai Fight. with the low kicks. It seems that Yunus Benali just doesn't have an answer for it.
Seems that way. Sometimes you see fighters in this situation switch stances to try and protect that leg. Round two in the books.
And Aaron, I think we're both in agreement that that was a big round for Poirier.
Oh, 100%. I mean, he started well in that second round. I feel like he was told in the corner after round number one that he needed to come out and perform in round number two. He started well, but then Poirier just took complete control of the fight. And he was determining the pace of the fight. And of course, those low kicks were a big difference maker. And we can see in the corner they're trying to work on that leg, make sure that he can perform in round number three.
You gotta unload a boatload of Vaseline on that leg to keep it going.
Yeah, if we are correct, we do think that Yunus Benali has to knock out Poirier now in round number three, the third and final round now.
And let's not forget that Yunus Benali, he does have that knockout power. But fair to say, a lot of the power has been taken away from those low kicks of Poirier. Here we go, round number three. Going for the high kick. Good high kick there from Poirier.
Oh, left hand there from Yunus. But that sparked you. Poirier into action. Oh, my goodness.
Almost a sort of a wrestling takedown there from Yunus Benali. Now, things have really heated up in this third round.
I mean, Yunus clips him with a left hook. For whatever reason, Poirier then just decided to go after Benali.
What I'm saying, he's very unorthodox, he's very unpredictable.
He is.
Anything can come at any moment from Poirier.
So Yunus again looking for that left hook.
He's in the midsection, but a counter elbow by Yunus Benali.
That was a big elbow strike there by Yunus. And I think there's some blood coming from the mouth, or a lip maybe, of Poirier after that elbow strike. Right hand there, tempting left hook, not neither connecting.
You gotta love the composure though you see from Poirier. Just waits for the right timing. Doesn't rush into attacks. Has been caught a few times though.
There's that low kick. And again.
Oh!
Big uppercut from Poirier, knocking down Yunus Benali. He threw those low kicks. Yunus was expecting a third, and all of a sudden Poirier, out of nowhere, throwing that left uppercut, completely surprising Yunus Benali and knocking him down.
And that's what I'm talking about. Anything can happen at any time when Poirier is in the ring. He is just that unpredictable and that good.
Jumping switch kick there from Poirier. Yunus now doing exactly what he needs to do. He's chasing this fight. We believe you lost rounds one and two, and of course now with his knockdown, he's losing round number three as well. It's looking good for Poirier. Spinning back fist, left kick to the body. Sometimes the best type of defense is to be offensive. Poirier proving that here in round number three.
I mean, he's really good.
He is. Another fast low kick there by Poirier to that bruised leg of Yunus.
So many tricks under his sleeve. And every technique he throws, he pulls it off so well. No technique, I'll tell you what, for Poirier is lazy. So much power in them, so much thought goes behind them. He sets up his shots.
He's so quick as well.
And then Yunus Benali taking a liking to the slap there from Poirier, but what a matchup it was for Poirier.
You see them celebrating in the corner of Poirier. They are very happy with what they've witnessed from their boy. No surprises as well. Potential star in the making. He really has got everything that you need to become a superstar in this sport. Even the chin, proving it with that right hand that he took there from Yunus at the beginning of the round.
He's just such an exciting fighter to watch. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you, I get excited for every single Poirier Bairami Faralgo fight.
We used to say the same thing about Yunus.
We did.
How things change so quickly. There was that. It was almost like a left hook. The combination of a hook and an uppercut, really. But whatever it was, it was sensational.
We need to see a slow motion, man. There it is.
Superb. Poirier taking this one comfortably over Yunus Benali, making a big statement here tonight. Congratulations to him.
และผลการตัดสินอยู่ในมือผมแล้วนะครับ And the winner is White Corner Boya from Iran